So you can say what you want, I go hold a stronger, be who I'm supposed to be.
Tuning into WDRB Media, the voice of the community, the only station giving you double the information and inspiration. You're listening to Our Voices Radio, and I'm your host, Nichole, the creative midwife, trained, willing, and able to help you discover your creative voice and birth it for the world through whatever medium you choose to use. The sponsor for today's show is Our Voices LLC, a writing and editing consulting firm and entertainment studio ready to help you tell your story your way. For more information, go to our Facebook page at www.facebook.com/ourvoicesllc. Today's show is Craft My Rewrite, Dive into Dialogue. If you were with me last week, we dissected the intricate ways in which scenes can be constructed to push story, character arc, and plot, all while infusing every scene with tension and conflict. We looked at ways to add momentum to our beginnings and endings, as well as found ways to cut the fat in every scene we write. However, although every scene does not need dialogue, when it is necessary, the words should burn a memory in the audience's collective minds. So today, we explore the dialogue of our scenes. Diving into dialogue, first and foremost, tell the truth. As with every other pass we've done in your manuscripts, the dialogue pass is crucial because it's the language of your story, right? Now that you've reconstructed your scenes, you must scrutinize what characters say to one another and why they say it. To help you along, let's ask some key questions. Are your characters telling the truth? When you read the dialogue and you're looking over your scenes, are they really saying what needs to be discussed? Are they saying what needs to be said in the moment? Are they being truthful with one another, or are they hiding as usual? Next, when you're reading your dialogue, is this the way the characters will truly come at the subject matter? No matter what's going on or what your subject matter may be, perhaps it's a hard topic. Do your characters come at the scene with humor? Do they go straight in? What if it's an embarrassing moment? Is there a side door that your characters can have their conversation? Instead of going straight, they come in through like a side door in order to get into the conversation at hand. Is your scene confrontational, which means dialogue is just straight up and right in there? No dancing around the bush for these folks. Or perhaps your scene is deeply personal and public. So is the conversation kind of covert? Does it have double meanings? Some tricky puns? Also check, is truth of the relationship being revealed or hidden in the conversation? I mean, let's think about it. If you have a scene with two siblings, are they dealing with is it a public and private circus that they're having their conversation in? Are they who they are no matter who's around? Maybe you're dealing with a parental abuser. So the conversation that's being had with another character, is it public show and then private horror? So they are who they are in one setting. And then with someone else who's looking over their shoulder, there's somebody else. Perhaps you're having a conversation with two friends and they've been friends in public, but perhaps behind scenes, they're frenemies, not really friends at all. When you're looking over your scene and you're trying to figure out what's going on, who is supposed to win? Who gets the desired result at the end of the particular scene? What's being learned? How are people really being with one another? How are they reacting to one another in the conversation? If you're not getting to the truth of what's going on, scrap the dialogue and try again. Next, what aspect of the story is being unveiled in this conversation? And as always, when you're looking at dialogue, one of the last questions you even want to ask yourself is, should words be used at all? Sometimes a beautiful scene is nothing but silence. It's eyes, it's hands, it's a movement or no movement at all. It's action as opposed to anything used verbally. When we come back, we'll continue our discussion on Craft My Rewrite, Dive into Dialogue. You're listening to Our Voices Radio, and I'm your host, Nichole, the Creative Midwife. You're tuned in to WDRB Media, the voice of the community, the only station giving you double the information and inspiration. We'll be right back after the break.
I'm pressing towards the higher call. Lord, even if I have to walk alone, I'll go. Forget what's done. I'm moving on. Wherever you lead me, I'm willing to go. Through the rain, through the pain, as long as you're with me, I know that I can go. After this life, I shall wear a crown. And when it's my turn, I'll be ready to go. I know how rough this road will be. My heart is pure, I can endure the weight of this cross.
Ooh, now I embrace my destiny. Ooh. But to get a reward, I'm pretty sure that I may have to suffer loss. I go through the fire, I will not be burned.
Every struggle, every trial, only makes me wiser.
Call the Creative Midwife on Our Voices Radio, and I'm looking for artists to be guests on the show to promote your business and share how you decided to use your authentic creative voice. Interested? Go to my website at NicoleMPalmer.com. That's NicoleMPalmer.com, or email me at Nicole@NicoleMPalmer.com, and remember to spell it Nichole. Welcome back to WDRB Media, the voice of the community, and those streaming live through Free TuneIn Radio app and through iHeartRadio. You're listening to Our Voices Radio, and I'm your host, Nicole, the Creative Midwife. If you're just tuning in, we're discussing Craft My Rewrite, Dive into Dialogue on Our Voices Radio, and I'm your host, Nicole, the Creative Midwife, trained, willing, and able to help you discover your creative voice and birth it for the world through whatever medium you choose to use. Before the break, we were just getting into the discussion on truth-telling and dialogue. Often, I mean, if we're really being honest, we can look at our dialogue and know that we've only scratched the surface because the characters are not in peril with the information that was revealed in the moment. Now, When I say peril, it doesn't always mean danger. Sometimes it's about revelation into their own character that may put them in the hot seat with another character in the scene. Sometimes it's the scratch that allows the past to bleed into the here and now, screaming to be dealt with finally for the real healing to begin. Other times it's information that the character has been seeking from other places, only to realize that what had been kept the info at bay was asking the wrong questions from the wrong people. This is what we're going to discuss in this section. Diving into dialogue, getting to the good stuff. So I can hear you ask, what is the good stuff of dialogue? It's the conversation you've always wanted to have with someone, but you felt it was impolite, rude, crude, crushing, naked, too funny, witty, too forward, out of character, or just too darn brave. You know the moments when your brain was too slow on the uptake of real life to be able to say what you've always wanted to say? When writing, you get to have that moment back. You get to craft the words that wouldn't come out of your mouth in real time, but you can put them in the mouths of characters you create and the moments you want to see. Dialogue should be more than dispense information. Dialogue should push the envelope of story, character, relationship, emotions. My God, dialogue should be the palette upon which tension and conflict add color to the physical actions witnessed in the scene. So what I mean by that is this. You have a scene where people are hiding secrets, and they know the secrets have been hidden. Say it's a scene between a husband and wife, and the wife has been hiding an affair, and the husband knows she's having it. So they're trying to cook dinner, and it's loud pot banging, loud please and thank you, and just being rude and wrong. And finally, the person just says, "What?" And the other person says, "Do you love him?" Now we've got tension, but the tension was already in the actions, already in the trying to cook dinner, knowing that the other partner was cheating. And the question was like the elephant in the room that needed to be asked. And they just came right out and asked the question. That's what I'm talking about. You've got things going on, and then you have dialogue that makes it just that sweeter, just that more tension filled, because you don't know what's going to be asked. Then you go, so how do you do it on a practical way? You know, I talk all good game. I talk about how to change things. But when you sit down and put your fingers to the computer or your hand to the paper, depending upon which way you're doing your writing these days, you still have to figure out, how do I physically make this happen? So here's what I do. I go line by line, character by character. I question every word, utterance, and silence in the moment. I ask myself if I've hit rock bottom in the scene. Did I really get to the bottom of whatever was supposed to be discussed? Did I hit it, or did I dance around it? I ask, have I mined the moment from every angle? When you're thinking about dialogue, you want to be able to come at it from every which way possible until you get to the place that says, yeah, this is it. Have the character said what was needed to be said in the moment for clarity, relationship, character arc, emotion, character building? Dialogue needs to hit all of those areas. If it's not hitting those areas, throw it out. It's just words that are floating on a page that do nothing. Every line must land in the scene. Every word must have purpose. Otherwise, it's a throwaway. And I don't know about you, but I don't have time to write throwaway lines. I need every word to count for something. As I used to tell my clients, I'd say, look, it's got to earn its real estate. If the line is sitting on the page, it's got to earn its place to be there. Otherwise, it doesn't need to be. Next, does the line have emotion? We've got to have emotion in our words. For example, I was working with someone on a screenplay. The scene was kind of deep. The actions themselves filled with tension, but we were missing a line of dialogue that would land the plane of the scene and make that scene memorable. My writing partner and I, we were throwing lines back and forth to one another, just trying to find the rhythm of the moment. And in the midst of us just really working that out between she and I said the line of dialogue. And that was it. It was simple. It was touching and right at the heart of the moment, allowing the character to lay her soul bare in front of another character. It was a line of vulnerability, nakedness, truth, heartfelt and hard to hear. Both my writing partner and I, we sighed heavily at what the line did to the moment. It was the right line. It held all of the emotion in the character's heart while revealing a deepening relationship between she and the other character. A good line of dialogue needs to do that. Good line of dialogue needs to punch open the holes of what the characters have a hard time saying to one another. A good line of dialogue needs to open up the scene and allow it to breathe. A good line of dialogue allows more than just information to be shared. It's opening the door for secrets, opening the door of being naked, opening the door of the other character's heart, getting a glimpse of really what that character is made of. We get to hear secret fears. We get to hear secret desires. We get to hear dreams. We get to hear angst. We get to hear hurt. We get to hear pent-up frustrations or excitement, depending upon the scene you're trying to write. I love it when a nice line of dialogue cracks open a secret that the characters thought they were able to kind of hide from one another, and in actuality wasn't hiding anything. I like a line of dialogue that uses the old-fashioned literature tricks and does it masterfully. I like dialogue that surprises you, that you didn't think a character would actually say such, and in that moment the character gets a backbone. Or in that moment, the character actually laughs. And maybe it's the first time the character has truly, truly laughed. And it throws all the other characters off because that's odd to them. I love it when a line of dialogue makes someone else in the room blush unexpectedly. You get to see a piece of honesty, rawness, hear real humor, something that surprises the other characters that you didn't think would actually show up. After the break, we'll wrap up our discussion on Craft My Rewrite, Dive into Dialogue. You're tuned into WDRB Media, the voice of the community, the only station giving you double the information and inspiration. Don't go anywhere, because we'll be right back.
But I'm still here.
But I'm still here. All because of his goodness.
I'm a living witness.
I'm a living witness. Yeah. Miracles still fall from heaven.
'Cause he moves.
He moves when we don't expect him to.
And he knows
the doors that we face.
He speaks.
He speaks right before we stop believing.
He shows
his love through his grace.
So
I'll praise him with the timbrel and dance.
With the trumpet. should have been gone. Say this, hallelujah.
I'm Nichole, the creative midwife on Our Voices Radio, and I'm looking for artists to be guests on the show to promote your business and share how you decided to use your authentic creative voice. Interested? Go to my website at NicoleMPalmer.com. That's NicoleMPalmer.com, or email me at Nicole@NicoleMPalmer.com. And remember to spell it NicoleMPalmer. Welcome back to WDRB Media, the voice of the community, and those streaming live through Free TuneIn Radio app and through iHeartRadio. You're listening to Our Voices Radio, and I'm your host, Nicole, the creative midwife. If you're just tuning in, we're discussing Craft My Rewrite, Dive into Dialogue on Our Voices Radio, and I'm your host, Nicole, the creative midwife, trained, willing, and able to help you discover your creative voice and birth it for the world through whatever medium you choose to use. Listen. Writing dialogue isn't easy. In fact, outside of action, dialogue may be the most challenging thing to write because you want the conversations to sound as natural as possible and yet still be able to throw in some zingers that capture your audience's attention, forcing them to utter, "I'm going to say that next time." You want dialogue to sound like they could be having that conversation with you sitting at a coffee house, shopping at the grocery store, or overhearing two colleagues at the water fountain. You want to capture the heart of the moment between two characters who feel like old friends, true mother and daughter, or father and son, or lovers trying hard not to say goodbye. If you can do that in your work, you will create a timeless piece audiences will enjoy reading, watching, experiencing time and time again. All right, today I am assigning homework. So for all of my listeners who've been watching, who've been listening to my shows, you know that in a previous show, I mentioned exercises that help with creating great dialogue. Well, today I want you to watch your favorite TV or film. However, I don't just want you to watch it and just let the images fly over your face. I want you to concentrate on the dialogue. Listen to the rhythms of the characters' voices. Listen to the language that the writer put into each character's mouth. Ask yourself, how are the conversations different? Can you close your eyes and listen to the dialogue and still know which character is speaking? That's often sometimes I'll do in my own scripts. I will forget who's talking and just run the dialogue and see if I can picture in my mind which character who's speaking what. If in doing that, I see the right character saying the right thing, I've captured that character's voice, which means it's unique. It's not like anybody else in the script. Speaking of which, if you enjoy reading scripts, find your favorites on free online platforms. There are plenty out there. Just choose one. Look at how the writer constructed the scene and the dialogue to support it. Studying others' work has always illuminated questions for me. I recently did a whole study on the Star Wars series, The Mandalorian. Yeah, you guys know that I love sci-fi. So I was watching it and I learned a lot about structure, character, and movement. See what you learn from studying your favorites. Well, join us next week as we continue our discussion on writing well. Thank you everyone for tuning in. Continue to tune in every Friday at 2:30 p.m. That's 2:30 p.m. Eastern. Please remember to connect with me by going to WDRBmedia.com. Click on the radio shows tab and go to Our Voices radio page. Also, if you want to be a guest on the show or, you know, you just want some free advertising, reach me on my website at NicholeMPalmer.com. That's NicholeMPalmer.com. Or go to my Facebook page at www.facebook.com/Our Voices LLC. You can also leave me questions and I'll answer them on the page. You've been listening to Our Voices Radio, and I'm your host, Nicole, the Creative Midwife, on WDRB Media, the voice of the community, for double the information and inspiration. Until next week, thanks and peace. And remember, in the end, you must write the vision and make it plain.
But I don't let it break me, 'cause I'm still on my way. I